Welcome to yet another interesting video from Practical Ninjas. Every day, we hear that new smartphones getting released. In this age of competition in the smartphone industry, every brand tries to market their product with new set of features and technologies. The main component in any smartphone is the SOC used inside. The SOC stands for System on Chip. This video will focus on the SOC used inside the smartphones. Stay tuned till the end of the video to understand about the SOC. All the processing takes place inside this SOC, and any feature that the smartphone can support depends on the SOC. We hear about various SOC like Snapdragon 625, Snapdragon 835, MediaTek P25, etc. How do we know which is the best and powerful? We will try to understand some of the jargons in the processor industry. The first thing to understand is that the SOC is built on a specific architecture design. We may have heard about the ARM processors. What is ARM? And then what are Snapdragon, MediaTek, Broadcom? Well, ARM is the company that makes blueprints and the architecture of different processors. For example, Cortex-A9, Cortex-A53, Cortex-A72, etc. But never manufactures them. Other SOC manufacturing companies obtain license from ARM to build these processors and manufacture the SOC. So, the first thing in an SOC is the architecture or blueprint of the CPU. SOC can contain multiple CPU units and they need not be same. Example, Snapdragon 650 contains both Cortex-A72 and Cortex-A53. The next thing to understand about the SOC is the number of cores. We use specifications like dual core, quad core, octa core, and even deca core. They refer to the number of available processing units. Dual stands for 2, quad is 4, octa is 8, and deca means 10 cores. Depending upon the number of cores, that many simultaneous processes can be performed by the SOC at a single time. Having more number of cores reduces the time taken by SOC to finish a certain task. To understand this better, let us look at the water distribution analogy shown in the figure. In the figure, we can see two tanks. One is completely filled with water and the next one is completely empty. The task is to transfer water from one tank to another. Here, a single pipe is connected between the two tanks. It takes some time to transfer the water. Now, instead of a single pipe, let us connect another pipe, making the supply pipe a dual assembly. The time taken to transfer water is reduced here. Similarly, the time taken to accomplish the task of transferring water reduces if quad assembly, octa assembly, or deca assembly is used. Basically, we can think of these pipes as number of cores in a processor. More the number of cores, less will be the time required to finish a certain task by SOC. However, drawback of this is the power supply requirement. More CPU cores means more power is required, which drains the phone battery faster. The processors are built using lakhs and lakhs of transistors. The transistors keep on switching continuously. Tasks are accomplished when charges flow through these transistors and charges flow when transistor switches. The switching speed of these transistors is controlled by an external clock. The speed is determined by the clock frequency. We may have heard processors with 1.6 GHz frequency, 2 GHz frequency, and so on. 2 GHz means the clock will output 2 billion pulses in 1 second. Higher the clock frequency, higher would be the switching speeds in transistors, and thus it would take less time to finish a certain task. The next important aspect of SOC is on which technology the processor is built. There are many technologies present like 22 nanometer, 20 nanometer, 16 nanometer, 14 nanometer, etc. As seen earlier, we know processors are built using transistors and charges travel through these transistors. 14 nanometer refers to 14 into 10 to the power minus 9 meters. This is generally the width of the gate in a transistor. Less the distance, more would be the processor speed, and less would be the power consumption. Less the distance, the dimension of the SOC is also less. One might think there is not much difference between 22 nanometer and 14 nanometer. and how can it make considerable difference in speed and power consumption? Let us look at it in this way. Charges are nothing but electrons. The radius of an electron is less than 10 to the power minus 18 meters. So, for 14 nanometer, a charge has to travel 14 billion times its radius length. For 22 nanometer, the distance would have been 22 billion times its radius. To get this into perspective, consider electron as a soccer ball, a football having a radius of 11 cm. For 14 nanometer analogy, this ball has to travel a distance of approximately 1.5 billion kilometers or 956,000 miles. And for 22 nanometer analogy, the ball has to travel a distance of approximately 2.5 billion kilometers or 1.5 million miles. From these distances, we can understand the vast difference in 22 nanometer and 14 nanometer technology and how the latter is way better than the previous one. To sum this video up, we discussed how the SoC is built on the architecture blueprints obtained from ARM, the number of cores that make up a processor, the clock frequency, and how it affects the SoC performance, as well as the technology on which the processor die is based. The processors nowadays have become so powerful that they can run a full-fledged PC OS on it. Before ending this video, let us compare the Qualcomm Snapdragon 625 and MediaTek Helio P25 based on the parameters discussed here. Both the SoCs are based on 64-bit ARM Cortex A53 blueprints. Both are octa-core processors. Snapdragon 625 is clocked at 2 GHz and Helio P25 at 2.6 GHz. Snapdragon 625 is based on the 14 nanometer technology, whereas Helio P25 is based on 16 nanometer process. We would love to hear your comments on the video. Hit the like button and share the video with your friends and peers. To support us, click on the subscribe button and press the bell icon to be a part of our notification squad. You can check the links of other interesting videos in the description box. Until next time, stay calm and keep learning. Peace out.